You're the organizer here at the SOPA protest.
Yes, sir.
Downtown San Francisco here at the Civic Center.
Yes, sir.
And can you tell us a little bit, what's your name and who you're with?
My name is Jonathan Nelson, and I'm the founder of Hackers and Founders. We're actually the largest community of early startups in Silicon Valley. Last night, we just passed 5,000 members, and we're kind of the classic two dudes in a garage starting businesses. That's who comes to our events, and that's who we are. We have 12 other chapters globally and over 12,000 members worldwide.
Okay, and what was your concern about SOPA, and what got you involved in this?
So my concern about SOPA and the PIPA legislation, which is specifically what we're out here today for, is just looking through that, it's pretty clear to me that the way the legislation reads is really not technologically savvy, the technological parts of it are very skewed towards people who have a mountain of copyright that they would like to protect. If I had 100 years worth of content that I needed to kind of protect, and if somebody else took that and put that online, I'd want to sue them out of existence. I mean, I understand that. But at the same time, you have this entire digital industry that has sprung up overnight, and the way the SOPA and PIPA legislation reads would break that digital economy. And I think kill thousands of little startups, baby companies all over the world that are trying to innovate.
So in the 90s, we had companies like Napster, and the music industry was very successful in shutting them down. And so, you could maybe even make a case that pirated music is not as prevalent as it used to be in the 90s, at least from a percentage-wise of internet users. So why do we need, why are they doubling down now with the SOPA effort, in your opinion?
I have no idea. I mean, things that I've been reading from Google and from Twitter and from other people that are really advocating about this is, the media industry has been profitable for the last decade. The laws that are actually on the books now, they work. The Digital Millennium Copyright Act, if I have a website and if I have digital content on my website that's copyright, they send me a notice, I have a certain time frame to take that down. That system works. The laws on the book work. I have no idea why would they have something so draconian, radical, in my opinion, and ham-fisted, kind of push that through at the last minute.
I mean, another example is obviously iTunes is very successful. Netflix now is monetizing very, very well. Hulu is now monetizing their content. So again, there was another YouTube video of a guy talking about SOPA, and one of the things that he pointed out was in the last 10 years, sites like CNET and AOL was heavily promoting downloads of Kazaa and LimeWire. These companies were owned by large media companies, and now they're pushing for SOPA. What are your thoughts on that contradiction?
I have really no idea. I mean, Reddit.com is actually their parent company is Condé Nast. They were purchased by Condé Nast years ago. I have no idea. I don't understand, and I think Silicon Valley is in the same frame of mind, that we just profoundly don't understand why this legislation was rammed through Congress, and what else are people supposed to do but literally break the internet for a day in a controlled fashion with how they feel that this ham-fisted legislation would break it permanently.
So today, you're talking about
the digital protests.
The digital protests. What are some of the examples of what happened today?
Wikipedia has 20 million articles online. They're a nonprofit. They went black or essentially shut themselves off and redirected all of that traffic elsewhere. Reddit.com went black or had a front page. You can't access any of Reddit's content. They have 2 billion page views a month. All of that traffic was directed elsewhere, directed at people calling their legislators.
Yeah, I didn't see anything on Facebook, sadly.
Yeah, different companies have different angles and different takes on this. Facebook, Quora, I don't know where they stand on it. I've talked internally with people at like Microsoft. I know there's a lot of discussion internally in their companies. I know there are some people in this audience from those companies that are very passionate about this issue, but I don't think officially they can kind of make a public stance on an issue like this. I can't really speak for them, though.
Circling back to going against the self-interest of even the industry that's promoting this. For example, Warner Brothers, I'm just thinking out loud here, but let's say Warner Brothers has a movie that they want to have promote, right? They have a website for it. They probably have a forum where fans can discuss the movie. Well, if somebody posts a link to a site of that violates copyright, that site will go down. So it's even against the industry that's promoting this. I mean, it's perhaps maybe the message would go to the industry saying, hey, wait a minute, you know, what you're doing here is not to, I mean, it's almost, it's kind of weird that this is even, that we even have to be here today.
It really is. And I mean, I understand, I heard some people on, I heard a interview on MSNBC a couple of days ago with one of the lawyers for Viacom, I think it was Viacom, and he was actually saying, you know what, the point is specifically to shut down piracy that's happening overseas. I think the problem that's happening overseas is that these companies' digital product hasn't reached there. I mean, I was in Spain this past fall. I was just trying to watch a video on Hulu, trying to watch a download and pay for a video online at Amazon.com. I couldn't. There was no way for me to do that, or at least I didn't know how to do that in Spain. After 4 hours of trying to make it work, I was really tempted to just to pirate something. I decided not to. But what I think the issue is that their digital product overseas is inferior, and I think that what they're seeing is actually demand for their product. I think if they had a great technical product, if they could innovate, if they could provide that product at a great price or at the right price point overseas, I don't think they would actually see this problem with piracy. Instead, I think they're actually finding it easier to spend millions of dollars in lobbying and actually tell Congress to actually sue companies in the United States that might actually have links to those outside companies that are overseas.
Yeah, they there was a young gentleman out of England who just lost a court case fighting his extradition to the United States, and all he had was a website that linked to other websites that provided questionable content or copyrighted content, allegedly.
Yeah, I mean, one of the examples I was thinking of was, you know, the Happy Birthday song is actually copyrighted. So what if I actually had a website that made it really easy to email grandmas singing Happy Birthday to their little girls or to their granddaughters?
You'd be in violation of copyright.
Yeah, if I emailed a link to all of my family of my grandmother singing Happy Birthday to my daughter, I would be in violation of copyright. But the email provider would be responsible for disseminating mass piracy.
Hmm.
That's insane.
Yeah.
I don't think the average person, if they understood that that's what this legislation would allow people to do.
Well, it'll turn you into a felon, right?
Yeah, you'd be a felon. I mean, it's...
Yeah, I mean, to a certain extent, SOPA, you could almost say that that's really going for your throat, in a sense. Of your civil liberties. I mean, not just of the technology. It's not just an issue of the technology industry. This is should concern any U.S. citizen that uses the internet.
Absolutely. I mean, there's a lot of soccer moms out there that love to share material. If there's music playing in the background on the radio while they're shooting a video and they share that,
you're a felon.
They're a felon. And I just don't think that people understand that this is the kind of stuff that would actually be enabled by this legislation. And that's why these huge measures were taken by technology companies today to try to educate.
So can you tell us a little about what about this this event here today? How did you decide to organize it? Who did you call? What kind of response did you have?
This was essentially, I got an email 4 days ago. We organized our events through meetup.com. It was actually people at Meetup in New York and at the New Tech Meetup. In New York, they actually have 20,000 members. They contacted me and a number of the community organizers out here of community support groups for startups to say, hey, can you guys hold a protest? We're having a protest. And we were like, okay. So I stayed up for 36 hours yesterday in front of my computer, sending out as many emails as I possibly could, asking people to tweet, trying to get as many people involved. And it was essentially just a handful of people trying to pull strings and trying to communicate online and sharing links to the event and sharing, you know, information back and forth that actually kind of enabled this.
Great. And can you give us, our viewers, your webpage again?
So we're at hackersandfounders.com. And our meetup is at www.hackersandfounders.com. I would love to be able to actually like program and fix that little mistake, but I'm too busy organizing stuff like this.
Well, you did a great job.
Thank you,
appreciate
sir.
Your time.
Thank you very much, and thanks for being out here, guys. Thank you.